Hello, my name is Rob Helene. This is your Asian session preview for Thursday, March the 18th, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. It's not an alert service. Currency coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of the trading day. Please bear in mind, when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business. Therefore, prior to live trading, please ensure you have a successful track record on your broker's demo account. Okay, guys, I want to cover a lot of little things off today. All around the euro, the more analysis you do, it can change your trade plans. You know, maybe not the big picture of where we're going. We might still think we're going to come up to this region somewhere up here, but just might have a little stall in the process before we're going to do it. And you know, what does that mean for us? Let's just have a little look around and just see what evidence there is that might be causing something like that, and how we can approach it and just take some caution. Just where we are right now, through here, you know, we're making higher highs, higher lows, you know, technically on a daily chart. Nothing stellar. But you can't help but see what we're in a little area of hesitation through here. Okay, we're in the downtrend. Back in February, price hesitated in this little zone for a number of days, and now we're back in that zone. That already there are signs that we're looking to do very similar. Okay, so this is the first heads up that maybe in this area we are gonna struggle a little bit. Okay. Now, what's compelling, what's got my heads up is not necessarily what I'm seeing in this pair, okay? But I potentially do see us coming down some ways, even below 136. I'm not going to be surprised on the daily even if we do something like this, that we could come down and almost back to a downtrend and then resurrect ourselves to an uptrend, okay? And that's just going to mean like maybe the rest of this week and next week, you know, red candles on a weekly chart, no big deal. If we just take a look at it on a weekly, you know, if we had finished this candle this week similar to where we are now, and then got a red weekly candle, that's no big deal because that could just be viewed then as a higher low with respect to previous on a weekly chart. No big deal. Just think about that for a minute, okay? Now, why would I say that? What would be giving me that thought process? Well, just check this out on the Swissie. Check out this Swissie weekly chart. It's gonna plot here the weekly uptrend we're in using price action, higher highs and higher lows. And we're right back in an area of this roll reversal and a weekly 21 and a psych level 10500, where you might like a little gander to the long side on this. I know it's a weekly chart and the daily's, you know, coming down and all the rest of it, but I'm not going to be surprised. I mean, this is, you know, pump the brakes time. This is potential. If I'm heading down, guys, I'm probably going to have to do this first. Okay. And by the way, guys, there's every reason that I've done enough pullback here to warrant something like this over the coming weeks. Okay, well, that inversely is going to affect our euro. If this comes up in any single way, our euro is going to come down. And I just think relatively, you know, the Swiss is obviously relatively weaker than the euro. It's reached support already, and I think a lot of traders are going to see this. Maybe try and push this Swissie up from here, and that's going to push that euro down. Also, check this out. The Aussie, which I think's been a leader. This is the Aussie daily chart. The Aussie that's been a leader in the USD pairs, I think, it's reached an area of fairly solid resistance now on this daily chart. Something we've been planning out in boot camp and, you know, looking to get long. Well, the last, you know, maybe potential last long has happened last night. Okay, we've reached this. I would expect at least some sort of reaction, if not now, a full fib of this move, and potential the daily to start looking like this over the coming weeks, and come down maybe to something like 89 before it might look to continue its uptrend. But I think the key piece of information here is resistance, back to resistance. It's definitely not a long there, I don't think. If anything, I'm going to be looking to get short there, if anything, off that technical level, and looking to get long where it makes sense later on in the piece. Well, if that's going to be doing that, well, what do you think that euro might start doing? Relatively, Aussie, very much relatively stronger than the euro, but you can't help but think that we might get some USD strength out of this, and see what happens from there. Okay. Also, just check out the DX chart very quickly. The DX chart for this pair has done enough, I think, to warrant. I'm just going to slide the DX chart across here for you to take a look at. The DX chart's done enough to, it's back to pretty much a 382 swing fib on a weekly, pretty much as well. So it's now in a zone where it might look to get a little bit of response as well. Okay, so the idea, guys, it's not a video to get long the USD here by any stretch of the imagination, but there is evidence that we are going to get some sort of rollover. Okay, if we check out the Euro 4 hour. I think it's already showing signs of weakness to the upside. Just when you look at it like this here, I think yesterday's price action, or the previous day's price action, had us in a nice uptrend on the 4 hour. That was our last video. I'll highlight it in yellow. This was an indecisive day. We had a weekly up, 4 hour down. Well, the daily bulls won that day, and we've trucked on up. Now, I can't help but think that traders are going to see that as a pullback swing long, okay? And now we've broken this previous swing, and traders might start thinking, okay, maybe this is the next best trade plan for this pair. A little pullback short of some nature, okay? So that's what potentially I think things are looking at today, and starting in Asia, maybe is, maybe swing trades to the short side, otherwise just spot trading your way around where it makes sense, using your pivots, psych levels, fibs, etc. on shorter term charts to inject yourself into something and see how it goes. One other pair, just before we end for the day, has been the CAD, and the reason why I'm fine. This is the weekly chart I have here. The reason why I find this compelling, it's about one of the only pairs out there that's actually every time frame, monthly, weekly, daily, 4 hour, everything is down on this pair right now. That makes it generally the easiest to go and trade. No counter trend trading at all. You see, there's a lot of support on a weekly through here. Well, the last attempt at that support level is broken through. And it's coming down, and this has parity at $1 lined up. Okay, I think it's got a very good chance of getting there. It's not currently showing us any opportunities to get in, but I do think, fibbing maybe your way around a 4 hour chart is very worthy of a little shot. Maybe back to a 21 EMA or something like that. Any sort of swing pullback short, I think, is very much worthy of a shot on this pair. Now, how far can this go? Well, obviously, parity at a dollar makes sense. If you wanted any sort of other proof that we could still continue coming down a notch, maybe we'd have to go to an oil chart. I'm just going to slide open the latest oil contract. And just put up the weekly here. Let's zoom in. This is where we're at on a weekly chart. Can't help but feel that we're trying to ride this this 5 EMA and break to new highs, okay? And this is the target I have just through here at about $86 for oil. And that's just based on these lows through here. Around 80, oops, just having trouble getting it across. Maybe I'll just zoom back out there. Just these lows through here. Just roll reversal, longer term. Obviously, that zone around 86 was a huge support area in the past. Well, we're nearing that again. If it gets up there, you can bet that CAD's going to get down to a dollar. So keep your eye on it, guys. The CAD might be potentially one of the easier pairs to trade. This euro's, you know, starting to look a little bit interesting. I'm itching towards short-term bearish on it until proven otherwise. We'll see how it goes. Otherwise, probably be lining up a CAD on a decent-sized pullback. That's my video, guys. Have a great day, and we'll catch you later. Cheers.